学びをしている。
はい、学び直してる。
おなおしてる。It means to learn, to relearn.
Yep, to relearn.
So
Relearn what?
the phrase is relearn the technique of
Yeah.
transformation.
Perfect. The transformation technique. Perfect. This is the line from the book. Can you read it for me?
It is 遠いでも変身の術がきちんとなければの話だが。
Hi. And our context that left off with everybody saying, okay, I'm gonna go send the boy to act as a spy to that magician's meeting that's happening tomorrow. So continuing that line of thought in Nevery's diary, what does he think?
You say toi demo, meaning to s saying, speaking of that,
Well, what does Mo tell us?
even if that,
Hi, even saying that.
is even saying that to you, toi demo, even saying that, self-transformation technique, kichin to kakareba no.
No.
If he correctly speak,
What
if
did
the
Kakareba
transformation
mean?
spell started
Yes.
complete.
Yes. If depending on whether or not we can correctly do the henshin no jutsu, right? That's
But
what the
then there's
hanashi is about.
non.
What is this hanashi telling us? This is something that we don't directly translate to English because our word hanashi, story, is not really what you would use here in English.
This Hanashi is to speak. No,
A
Iyu is
little
to speak.
bit.
Hanashi is a
You is to
story.
speak. That's correct. It is story in quotation marks. I would, in this context, perhaps translate it as situation.
Situation.
That is a vocab word you could
Oh,
pick.
so then the sentence say that Daga, meaning he's unsure. So he say
Not really. It's not a
so
dishol.
Da he's Da
What does
is a
ga mean?
statement. Ga is like the subject marker, or
It
at the
means
end of the
but.
sentence is a quote, is a but.
Yeah, ka is a question marker. That is correct. But if you add the tenten marks into ga, that is the word but. So it says, however, even saying that, this is a hanashi that is only true, that like it's only depend, it's a story, it is a situation that depends on whether or not the magical spell is actually cast correctly. What situation is he talking about?
Spy
Hi, the spy
that he can go in
situation.
as a spy.
Exactly. Yep. So he wants to send the boy at the spy, but he's not going to just say, hey, boy, walk into that meeting as your normal child. He's like, I have to transform the boy into something in order for it to happen. So that's only a plan if he's able to actually cast the spell. Do you know how to read this word right here?
Okorikomo. To send
Okurikomo,
away
hi.
or to send in.
Yes, the send in, perfect. And what does tazuneru mean?
To ask,
Perfect. How
to
about
inquire,
taberaremai?
tazuneru.
What does that mean?
Taberaremai. Can be eaten or cannot be eaten.
Yes, it shall not be edible. Yes. What is this word right down here?
Sumaru.
Ah, atsumaru.
Tsumaru. Atsumaru,
Right.
to gather.
Perfect. What's this word right here?
Oi kakete. To caught up.
Yeah, to catch up. Perfect.
Was caught up.
Yeah, I mean the sentence here. So Japanese, right? Tense is only located in two locations. The location is either at the end of the sentence or at the end of a relative clause. Those are the only times you're going to be seeing tense. So our tense is down here, which is what makes oikakete into past tense, right? The ta is saying, ah, this was caught up. But oikakete on its own doesn't actually have a tense. It's just the verb, and you have to follow until you get a tense, such as iru or tazuneta here. So this word, yeah?
Oi kakeru is a transitive verb, right?
Yeah, you're not gonna make something else catch up. Wouldn't really make any sense. How would you do that? I make the kid catch up, like you yell at them. You would have to do, like, it doesn't really
I mean,
have a natural idea for it.
so it's intransitive. I was caught up.
Yeah. Yes, I catch up.
Something ca caught up to me.
No, I catch up.
Was I who caught up, or something catch up?
I catch up. Ore
I
wa
catch up.
oi kakete tazuneta. I catch up and ask. O as a
Okay.
verb, o means, what does o mean?
O is to chase after.
Yeah, you already know it means to chase, right? So you already have an idea that this is not done to yourself unless you conjugate it, whatever. Do you know what kakeru means normally?
Is to put on.
Yeah, it can mean to put on, to start, anything like that. It has lots of meanings. So by default, if you just separate out the words, you should already be able to tell that it's not passive form. It's not a passive verb. So it's I chase. I chase in a way that allows me to catch up. So I catch up to them. So this word means to expel, which is why we have dasu, which means to make something exit, to make something appear. Can you read this for me?
Oi dasu.
Right. Oops. What is the if form eba of oidasu?
Oi daseba.
Hi, oidaseba. If you chase, when you chase. Let's go read the line from the book.
Kozo ga tatsu ni.
Yaku.
Yaku ni tatta nai. Yaku is to hit, right?
Oh, what did you say? Hi.
Yaku is to strive.
No, yaku means duty. For example, yakunin is a government official.
Yaku
Hi.
min
So
duty.
if you're unable to
Sorry.
stand, if you're unable to stand for duty, what does that actually mean?
Yaku ni tatta nai to wattara.
No, pause here. What if yakuni Tatanai means can't stand for duty as a literal translation. Do you know what this actually means? Literally, he's not actually talking about someone like at a soldier having their duty they have to do. This has a different meaning. Yakuni tatanai from yakuni tatsu.
That mean that he can't perform the task.
Exactly. In other words, this means useless. So yakuni tatsu is useful. You're able to stand at duty. Hi. Now you can continue.
Yakuni tatta nai. Oh, right? Toll, mark.
Hi.
Wakatara. Wakaru, to understand.
Hi, what do you understand?
If he un or when he understand, when he understand that he's useless,
Who's useless?
the Kozo.
Hi. So in this case, it's when I understand is how I would translate this.
When I
So
understand.
if is a little bit better in this context, as way down here at the tense, which is why it's always good to read the whole sentence. But way down here at the actual tense here is future tense here, even though this is tada just has to have ta form. There's no that's not actual tense, that's fake tense. So it's actually if I understood that the boy is useless, what would Nevery do?
I should send him away.
Exactly. I should chase him away. It would be good if I chased him away. Perfect.
Oi,
And
oi, das
then,
eba.
hi. And then in the diary at the very last line, we have something written not by Nevery. Let's go read this.
It's a mesh sky no kozote. 誰のこと？今より。誰の？ Who is it? Who business is it? Who job is it? Who job is it to?
Good idea. So the word job is not in the sentence. Job is shigoto,
Who?
which does have a koto in it, but there's no shi here. I would start with this te. Do you know what this te is doing here? This is a slurring of something.
Teiyu,
Hi,
speaking of the
teyu.
boy
Yeah.
servant.
Toiyu. I personally were trying to say toyu noa, right? Meshitsukai no kozo toyu noa dare no koto? Or toyu koto wa?
As for the boy servants, who is it?
That is what it's saying. Who do you mean by boy servant? Kanyori.
Dare no koto?
What does kanyori
Who do
mean?
you mean?
Hi, dare no koto. Who do you
Kan
mean?
yuri mean from kan.
Perfect, from kan. And what does hanashi mean?
Nashi, speak.
What it
Nashi.
doesn't really mean speak though, but it
Oh.
tends to be used with a spoken thing, I guess. So normally
Hanashi
hanashi
is
in English is translated as story, but the word hanashi in Japanese is a little bit bigger than that, than the English word story. What how should we translate hanashi if you say toitemo henshin no jutsu ga kichin to kakareba no hanashi da ga.
if is the if that's the situation,
Yeah, that is
Hanashi.
the situation. If that's the story we're going with. Perfect. In this case, the kakaru, right? This is just to cast the spell kakaru. I don't know what I was writing up there as a note. It's just neba if. So if the magical spell is cast correctly, because kakaru is the vocab word for casting spells. So I'm not sure why it's like that. Do you know how to read this word? It's not oshieru is my hint. But it means oshi it's the pair it's the passive form of oshiru, so it's to be taught.
So
That's definitely
it's passive. I was
that's a
taught.
good guess.
I'm
So
being
this is
taught.
o so
Oh, so.
osowaru.
So what? I was taught. Oh, so what?
Perfect. Can you read this whole sake page?
Right. So. Ryori なんて知ったことないけど、お座れば、 できるかも。できるかも。I might be able. できる、to be able. Might be able to be taught.
What does ba mean? Reba. Hi, I
If
might
I
be
was
able
taught,
if I'm taught. Exactly.
I might be able if I am taught.
Perfect. What does
The
shita koto ga nai mean?
shita koto nai
Hi.
kedo shita koto nai.
Hi.
Shita is from suru, so
Yes.
shita koto is the thing that was done.
Hi.
Nai. I'm confused with koto, Moni. Koto make me confused.
Koto,
Koto is this
a lot of
thing, but
times in
here it doesn't
English,
mean.
can be translated as the word thing. Just like the word thing in English, thing does not have to be a physical object. Thing can refer to events. Oh, I have a thing on Saturday. Do you see what I said?
So
I have a
if that
thing on Saturday. Thing here is an event. So here, koto is referring to an event.
So shita koto, thing done, nai,
Yes.
it
Yes,
was
it
not
was not a
done.
thing done. The thing was not done. So koto ga nai specifically me like cuz nai is like forever or future tense. It's habitual, right? Or future tense cuz it's like dictionary form basically. So it means this event is not done, will not be done, and has not been done in the past, kind of. Specifically saying it has not been done yet, I guess. Not yet done. So this thing that's not yet been done is normally used when you're referring to like actual events. So here the thing he has not that has not occurred, an event that has not occurred, is ryori suru. So it says the event of cooking has not happened. What do you think this actually means?
And I have not cooked before.
Exactly, that's 100% what it
However,
means.
I can do it. I might be able to do it if I am taught.
Perfect. That's exactly what it means. Do you know what ban means?
Bob mean evening.
Evening, yes. And that is the kanji for ban. What's the te form of this word?
For also waru also what that
With a glottal stop. Also watta. Also watte. Let's go read the example sentence.
my no ban evening before de shi wa ma chutsushi ni 魔法の術を教わった。The apprentice, was taught by the magicians the transform the magical technique.
When were they taught this?
Last evening,
Yeah,
previous
last
evening.
night. Perfect. What does dori mean, like in Setsume Dori?
Setsume is explanations.
Hi.
Doori is in that way, right?
Yeah.
Oh, all the way through.
Yeah.
Explain all the way.
That's a good guess. Setsume dori does not mean that. Dori comes from the word tori, which means street. And it's more like it's a one-way street that is just the explanation. So it means exactly as explained. There was no detours, in other words. Let's go read
Ex
this line from the book.
see. So, 次の日の朝、前の晩に粘りに教わった通りにマフィンを使ってみた。
right. For, in case you didn't notice, we switched to chapter six, so we're now Khan's POV.
See. So he said, the next morning, tomorrow, the morning tomorrow, I will try to make muffin according to Nebri, what Nebri taught me the night before.
Hi, exactly. So the mita here is past tense. So he says the next morning, just like continuing the story, right? So the next morning I had tried to make muffins, right? It's like you're telling the story to someone, and I did it the way Nebri tried to teach me the night before. What does yaku ni tatsu mean?
Yakunitatsu is to be useful.
It is to be useful. Perfect. Do you know what jutsu means? Like, skoshi jutsu?
Jutsu, it's like very much of something.
Close. It's like bit by bit. Skoshi jutsu means a little by little. That's how you translate it. So it kind of, it's like by and then repeats the previous thing that's like before it, basically. Skoshi jutsu, little by little. This word down here means decrease. Do you know how to read it?
Decrease henshaw.
Hi, Gensho. Perfect. Yeah. Can you read this adverb for me?
The adverb shojo.
Hi. In this case, there is no rendaku, sadly. You'd think there would be. Like tokidoki, but for whatever reason, sho doesn't get the rendaku. So sho, any idea what it means?
A little bit, a
Yep,
few
a
of
little
something,
bit. Teeny tiny
like
bit.
Sukoshi.
Small quantity. Exactly. So how do you read this kanji?
Sure.
Perfect. Let's go read this example sentence.
Sure. These are copper coins.
Hi.
So it's reading is どうかを差し出した。I produce.
There is a appearing here. Sasu means like to stab, and in this context, it's like to present. So I present, I show, I offer up.
I show a few coins.
Hi,
Sasu.
perfect. And it's a show in a kind of like an offering kind of way. Like they don't have to accept the offering, but it's like the picture I was trying to draw where you'd have the. It's like if a kid gets like a snake and they're like, "Look at the snake!" Like that very specific like. Hand action. You could take the snake from the hand, right? But you don't have to take it if you don't want to. So it's that kind of showing where the little kid like sticks up their hand toward you. Do you remember how to say fireplace? Hi, Danro.
Danro.
Perfect. And how about to blaze?
Blaze is ome or
Close. Mo. Moeru.
moeru
Moeru.
moeru moeru moeru.
You know what shio is?
Shio is a wall.
No. Wall is kabe.
This is so.
It is salt. Yes. This is the kanji for what? How do you read it?
Manju for salt.
Hi, shio. So this word right here is a word we haven't seen in a long time. Any idea how to read it?
Oh, we forgot something about
Totally.
ash color.
It does have to do with like ash, specifically charcoal. This is starts with sumi. Any idea what it ends with?
Sumi hole.
Good guess. So you're thinking about honol, right? Which looks like this. Right. Two fires. What is fire on its own?
It's he or
It
ka.
is he. So this becomes sumi he. Is there rendaku here or no rendaku?
Sumi with Renfaku.
Hi, sumi
Sumibi.
be. So yeah, that is a charcoal fire. So all that means is that it's a fire that is cooking on top of charcoal rather than a fire that is cooking on top of like wood or a electric fire or something or a magic fire. That's the only difference. Can you read this example sentence for me?
Shiro ga kakatta mono. The thing to. Okay, the salt started the thing.
That is a good guess. You're right that kakadu can mean to start. 100% correct. The other meaning of kakadu was to cover, right? To
The
hang up.
salt sprinkled the thing.
Yeah, the thing covered in salt, sprinkled with salt. Exactly. And is salt shiro, shiru, shio, or shiu?
So it's Shiro.
Shiro?
Shio.
Shio, hi, shio. That is correct. It's shio. I thought you said roll, but I don't know. I
I
always want to
did.
double check.
I totally did.
Magireru. Any idea what that means? Magireru.
Magi. Magi
Magireru.
sound like a swim.
This is not conjugated in any special way. This is not passive form. It's magireru.
I don't know money.
Right.
Magi
Magi redu is to mix into something, but specifically to be mixed in, right? Ore wa and sorry, kurayami ni magirete wakimichi kara deru to jiisa no haigo ni shibuyaku shinobu yotta. So it says, I blend myself into the darkness and I exit from the side street, and right after I exit from the side street, I sneak up swiftly right behind the old man. Magirete, to mix within. So, very similar, but funnily enough, totally different kanji is the word mazeru. Any idea what mazeru means? Right. Right. It is very similar to magireru. What did magireru mean?
To mix in with something else.
Hi.
Or to be mixed in.
Yes, to
Is
be
it
mixed in.
passive?
So this one, right? Magireru? Yes. It is the same as passive form.
So this is the active version of it.
Yes, it is to mix. They have different kanji, but they sound similar and have the same meaning basically. So to mix, mazeru, which is a ru verb. What is the stem form of mazeru?
Mazeru stem form is mazeri.
Hi, maze. Perfect. Let's go read this
Mazeru by
example
itself?
sentence. Yeah, just maze.
So it's a root verb, basically. Shio ga kakata mono.
Sorry, the button got clicked right there. This my thing right here is you can't see it, but there's my buttons I have to click so, for clearing and drawing. So I accidentally clicked something I wasn't supposed to. So this is actually what we're supposed to read.
Deshi wa shio to bata 少々を混ぜる。
Perfect.
The apprentice mixed the butter with the salt.
How much? A lot?
A
A little
few,
bit.
a little
Yeah.
bit.
A little bit's fine. Can you read this word for me?
I think he mixed the salt with the butter. It's not
Yeah.
that he mixed the butter with the salt. It's a little bit of salt, not a little bit of butter, I'm guessing.
I think it doesn't, in this
It
specific sentence, it doesn't really matter. Neither of them are like being given that much. Like the shosho is really actually modifying the mazuru. Here, it's just
Oh,
saying there's a
sorry.
little bit of mixing going on with these items rather than really being about the quantity of the butter and the salt.
It's an adverb. It's not an adjective.
Yeah. But
Okay,
yeah,
got it.
read this word.
Maze owaseru.
Ah, awaseru.
Ah, owaseru.
Hi. So this also means to mix. This just kind of feels like to mix well. It feels like you've kind of completely mixed something. Do you know what noseta means?
Noseru?
Yeah, noseta.
Noseru?
Te no hira ni noseta madoseki.
To get on something, right?
Yeah, it's similar to that, but it's not I get on.
Te no hira ni noseta mado.
Seki.
Seki wa.
The Madoseki is doing
The
noseta at this location.
it's sit on.
Yeah.
It's sit in
It's
the palm
set
of.
on the palm of the hand. What is the te form of
Yeah.
mazeawaseru?
The form is maze awasete. A lot of stuff. Was it that?
I believe it doesn't have a glottal. I'll double check though. Yeah, no glottal stop. It's
No
just maze
glottal.
awasete.
Hi, because
Let's
the
go
stem form is
read.
awase.
Yes, exactly. Let's go read the example sentence.
Maze awaseta mono wa o. Frying pan ni. This word is to line up. Nabe.
All right.
Nabe?
Not
Nabe
a
ta?
not not a bit.
Narabe ta. Narabe ta. Frying pan o danro no sumibi. No, we need to set up. Okay, two sentence. First is, I mix mase awaseta mono. What is the mono referring to right here in the first sentence?
It's not particularly referring to anything. The sentence here is I narabedu.
I line them up.
Hi, what are you lining up in the fry pan?
I line up the
Mono.
frying pan ni the mono. I lined up the thing that I
Things.
mixed.
Hi. That's exactly what it says. I lined up the thing that was mixed in the frying pan.
Frying pan o danro no. Sumibi no ue ni no seta. I place the frying pan on top of the charcoal in the
Is it just charcoal?
fireplace.
Is it just charcoal? Is it like a cold charcoal in the fireplace?
It's a burning one. It's
It's a burning
hot
charcoal. Hi,
charcoal.
hi. Perfect. So, fukurashi ho. The most important part here for us is this coat right here. Whenever you see this little coat, this is going to mean some kind of powder-like substance. Fukurashiko, for example, comes from fukurasu, which is to poof up. So this is baking powder, right? That's the thing you put into food so it poofs up. I started with fukurashi. What did it end with?
Fukurashi coat powder.
Perfect. Can you read this example sentence for me?
Fukurashi coat to ishio o frying pan supan de maze awaseta
Hi, spoon.
spoon. Oh, with the spoon, I mix together the baking powder and the salt. Fukurashi.
Perfect. So chikiru
Rashi.
is a u verb. Any idea what it might mean?
Iru. Chi is like, is that the kanji for 1,000 money, or is that the
It
kanji
is the
for
kanji for 1,000.
So, kiru is to finish.
Hi. In this case, it is actually more like the actual cutting meaning for once in its life. Chigiru. This means
So,
to to shred something or to tear to pieces. So the idea is that you cut it so you have 1,000 pieces. Chigiru.
shred it? Like shredding cheese?
Yeah. Right? If you got cheese, you could cut it and you'd have this many pieces. But if you shred it, you have how many pieces of cheese? 5, 10, 1,000? How many pieces of cheese do you have if you use a
Here,
cheese grater?
right.
Right?
Many, many.
Many, many,
So cheat
exactly.
here for
So
many
that's where
different,
that
yeah.
comes. The reason why it's not really like to be done is because this chi here is a noun, right? It's I don't think that's a verb. Could be wrong. Is there a verb with the 1,000 kanji in it? I don't know. I guess I can check if there's a urdu with that. Yeah, there's no kanji there. So this is a noun. So because there's no other verb, the verb has to be this one. It's just a verb that's compounded with this noun. Whereas if you have two verbs, then this one gets first like priority. Do do do.
Chigiru.
Chigiru to make cut into 1,000 pieces. What is the te form of that?
That form would be chigit.
No, you're right.
Chigita.
Yep, but the
But
glottal stop.
I can't figure out whether it's half glottal or not glottal. Half
It
the
has
time I just
glottal.
guess.
Kiru is kitte. It has this little pause. Kitte. Let's go read the example sentence.
Yes. Oh, amazing. Fushigi. Oh, not Fushigi.
It's gone. You can't see it anymore. It was
It's
leftovers.
ni mizu to
Bye.
fukurashi ko o. Water and baking powder.
Hi.
Moku. Is it moku? Is
I
that
personally
moku?
would
It's something
translate it as
else.
ki, but
Keen.
it is common for that to be read as moku when it's combined with things, like in this kind of context. But because no's afterwards, ki would be better.
Oh, it's keen no spoon de. The wooden spoon. Maze awase. So I mix using a wooden spoon. The baking powder and the water.
Right.
Mix the baking powder and the water using a wooden spoon. Soreo. That chigita.
Hi.
And then I forgot the word. I graze it.
You can just
I
say cut. Shred is a better word than
shred.
to grate. Because grate is something you only do to cheese. You shred chicken. That's when you tear the chicken into teeny tiny pieces. That's what I was thinking when I heard the word shred. I've never heard shred cheese. Even though there is like shredded cheese, so I guess it does make sense. But it's just, I've never heard like heard someone say, "Oh yes, I shred the cheese today." Because instead you say, "I grated the cheese," but it is shredded cheese, so it's just kind of funny. But the how you think of the verbs go like that. But in this case, I just would say I cut it into a lot of pieces. I cut to a thousand
I
pieces. So that's all you're
cheated that.
doing. He's not actually shredding this in this context. He's mixed these two things together and he's basically just making a bunch of little things of it.
Cheated that.
Can you read this word
Sorry,
for me?
cheated that. Ko mugi, ko mugi, ko mugi ba.
Oh, this was the powder word.
Ko.
Hi, 小麦粉.
小麦粉.
小麦粉 is flour, like the stuff you use to bake cakes.
You mean like the wheat flour we used to make bread with, right? 小麦粉.
Yes. That.
Wheat.
Hi.
Sorry, that's the word I'm thinking
Exactly. Wheat flour. Perfect.
of.
Yes. それごと
Oh.
means all of that, basically. This is used when you're referring to a specific object and things that are like attached to that object. Like, for example, you have a fry pan and you have a book sitting on top of that, and you say, "I moved the fry pan," you might think, "Oh, what happened to the book? Did it fall off?" Because it's not mentioned there. But if you said "それごと," we're like, "Ah, oh, we got the fry pan and the book sitting on top of that. We balanced it well." That's how it's basically used. So if you're referring to one specific item, but you're also acknowledging that other things are attached to that item, basically. So it's that along with some other things that are with it, but we're mostly focusing on the one thing. So it's that and similar items. Let's go read the line from the book.
はい。コソム、小麦、
小麦。
小麦粉、小麦粉、水、ふくらし粉、バター、少々と、塩を、木のスプーンでよく混ぜ合わせ。I mix well. Using the wooden spoon, a little bit of salt with butter, with baking powder, with water, and with wheat flour. それをちぎって、I shred them. Frying pan に並べ、line them up on the frying pan. それごと、暖炉の炭の上に乗せる。I place them on top of the burning charcoal in the fireplace.
What are you placing exactly? Like you translated it perfectly, but I'm just curious, what exactly are we placing on top of the like context? What are we placing on there?
I place the thing that I had mixed well together and
So we're
shredded.
just so we're only sort of directly on top of the fire, we are placing the mixed items that were shredded. That's what we're doing.
Hey.
So we actually have placed the frying pan there. That's why we have the goto. So the focus, you're right, is on the teared up how like substance that we made. But the goto is letting us know, oh, we're also taking the fry pan that we lined it in. So the character did not line it up in the fry pan, stand by the fire and start chucking the pieces of the substance into the fire. He's setting the frying pan on top of the fire, but there is a focus on the items in the frying pan rather than a focus on the frying pan. So the sore and sore here, same item, but the goto, what is the goto referring to?
Frying pan.
The frying pan, exactly. So that's why it's not sore o da danro no sumibi. We said sore goto. So we're saying that, and of course the frying pan. We want to make sure we know that Kanken did not throw the sore directly on top of the flame. That would be a disaster. And
Oh, he's
how?
making muffins.
He is making muffins. How do you read this word?
That's why he hit the butter.
So so.
Yakete
Hi.
ita. It
Cook.
grew.
Not grew. Cook. To roast. Yakeru.
Yakete ita. Hai,
Hi.
gross.
Can you read this phrase for
Yakete,
me?
yakete. Yakan no. Yabai. Not yabai.
It's like you from Oyu. Right? Hot water.
You like in hot water. So you got waita yakan no yakan no you yakan yakan like kettle the
Hi,
cooking
yakan
water.
means kettle. What happened to the kettle?
Yeah, they waita. Waita? They
Hi.
boiled?
Specifically, the you inside of the yakan waitad, which
The
you in
you.
general is probably going the waku. Pretty common.
Boiled. Waku.
Yes, it does mean to boil, correct. So the hot water in the kettle boiled. Is what that says. Boop. This is the same verb. The waita is also wakasu. It also means to boil. The difference, of course, is this one right here. It is the water boils, right? Ga. Wakasu is I make something boil. Oh. What's the
Hey.
bolded word on this page?
The bolded word is betsu.
I bet it. Wakasu. What did that mean?
Betsu is the active form of boiling, to
Yeah,
boil.
to boil something. What is the te form?
Is was kashite.
Wakashite. Hi. So let's go read the line from the book.
その後、別のフライパンを取り出して、ベーコンを焼き、やかんに水を入れて、
That's a good guess. That is theoretically possible if if you're saying possible to go in, but I don't think we're trying to say possible to go in the sentence, especially with the O right here.
水を入れて、
Hi, 入れて。
暖炉で湯を、沸かした。沸かす。かした。
Hi. What do you
沸
think
かす。
OU does? What's its job?
お湯。You all. The hot water is boiling.
Exactly. So altogether, what is saying? その後、別のフライパンを取り出して、ウェイケの焼き、やかに水を入れて、暖炉で湯を沸かした。
Say here that following that, その後、別のフライパンを取り出して、bacon or yaki. I cook the bacon, toridashi. I take a different frying pan to and cook the bacon.
Hi.
And then I also yakan ni mizu o irete. I put water into the kettle and onto the fireplace, using the fireplace, danro de, I boil the hot water. I boil
Perfect.
the you.
Yes, the hot water, the water. Why do we have stem form here with bacon no yaki, yakan ni mizo irete?
We have stem form because we are doing a continuous. We're saying that it's not a continuous thing. We do the bacon first, then we do the pudding with the water in.
Yeah, and it has a little bit of a separation. These two actions are not totally related to each other, right? This is in a kettle, this is in a fry pan. Why do we have irete in te form with a comma?
It because the Yakan, it's already in the fireplace,
Hi.
and we're just adding more water into it. I'm guessing
So
there's
you're not
already
actually
thing that's
adding water.
cooling
So
over.
this is the added water to the yakan. That is correct. That is what the sentence is saying. The te form here, this means and, right? Just like yaki also means and. This acts as a connector between two conjunctions, this one and this conjunction, and tells you something about their relationship. So just like you told me that this one tells us that these two have no relationship, but this happens first and then the next thing happens. What relationship does this clause have with the second clause, since we have te form with a comma?
It's either simultaneous or is causal.
Good
I
guess.
think it's
So
simultaneous here.
it's not simultaneous because there is a comma. Lack of comma. So you can't, so what, like, you know what the sentence is saying, right? It says I pour water and the water boils. If you poured water in something, should it be boiling instantly?
No.
No, that doesn't make any sense.
So
So
then it's
causative is
boiled.
closer. It does this happen and the next thing happens. That's correct. So causal is closer to what this is saying, if you had to pick between four, because the te form tells you this right here is an ingredient, a step in order for the second thing to happen. Is it possible for the water to boil if you did not put it in a kettle and on top of the fireplace? Would this water be boiling?
No,
No. So you had to first
it would
get the
not.
kettle and put water in it in order for it to boil. That's all it's saying. Versus here, the bacon cooking and the water being poured in the kettle doesn't really have any, like, relationship with each other. They're in two totally different containers. They're both near the fire. So both of these would have the link between fireplace being on. So fireplace being on, bacon would be, could have te form, or fireplace being on and kettle could have te form, because these two could be more li linked to each other. But there's no actual link between these two ideas. Well, there is a link here of ingredientness, is what I'm calling this. The reason why I'm saying ingredientness and not causation is because this doesn't necessarily cause that. It does allow for more freedom. For example, you could pour water in the kettle, put it on top of the fireplace, but the fireplace might not be lit, so then the water wouldn't boil. It's theoretically possible. So this does not mean the water has to boil. It means the opposite, that the water could not have boiled without the kettle having water in it. So it's like a reverse causation in a way. It just says the last thing is needed to accomplish the next one. A good example that is from some website when I originally learned this grammar, and I never want to say the sentence, but it's if you went to the store and bought fish, so you have fish now, you bought fish. You could have te form here if you said you made sushi at home, right? I went to the store and bought fish, so I made sushi. But the buying of the fish didn't make you make the sushi. You could have instead made sashimi, right? These are both things that have fish as a ingredient. But you could not make sashimi, nor could you make sushi if you did not first have a fish that you bought earlier in the day. So that's why it's not causing it, because it doesn't actually cause it, but it is a step one in a way in order to reach your next sentence, which is making some kind of dish with fish in it, since you bought fish. But yeah, that's about. Can you read this word? Yeah.
It's a necessary it's
Necessary
cause
component.
in the sense that it's necessary. Yes.
Yes.
It's a necessary cause. It's
Yeah. But
not
not
the
the lead
volitional
cause.
cause.
Lead cause is your brain, I guess. Or something else. Hi, hi, hi.
The Mizubi, Mizumibi, Sumi,
Komugi. Hi, Komugiko.
Komugi ko.
Which is flower. Boop a doop. A lot of reminder vocabulary. Remember how to read this guy? Perfect.
Tashikame.
Tashikameru. From Tashikamenuba. Do you know what Tashikameru means?
Tashikamenuba.
Hi. From
Nuba
Nakereba Naranai.
mean if not, if I'm not, if not.
Yes. If not. If not
If
Tashikameru.
not, if not, if not confirm.
Exactly. If not confirmed, meaning I must confirm. Perfect. Do you know how to read this word? It means wool.
Ito.
Hi. Ke. Keito. Kaka kaka. Do you know what a
Ito.
besto is?
Besto is like a coat.
Close. It's the vest.
It's
All
a
right.
vest.
Vest. Best. So yeah, Bennett had a
Almost like a
red woolen vest on earlier. Do you know what tameshimi
vest.
means?
Tameshini. Tame?
Hi, tameshi.
I don't know.
Tameshi is a very important word to know when you're going around random websites because tameshi yomi is really great. Tameshi yomi is a trial reading that you could read like the first like couple of pages of a manga or a novel if you're looking at ebooks, right? Tameshi yomi. So tameshi is a trial, a test of something, a confirmation, like tashikameru. Different kanji, but same idea. Trial. So here it says like he tests out when he tries to open up the gate or something. Do you know what shibarakushite means?
Don't know.
Shibarakushite is a time phrase, that's my hint.
For a while.
Yeah, for a while. Perfect. And how do you read this bolded word over here?
Keito.
Hi, Keito. Perfect. So here will be our last line of the day. You could translate this as test. That's a better word for it. Like a trial, a test, like rather than confirming.
Hitotsu, one piece. I gave a piece. I try a piece.
Yeah, that is what it says. I try one piece, is what it says. The shiken, do you know what that means?
Chicken is an exam.
Exactly. That's the same tame from tameshi. Shiken, test, trial. That's a good way to remember it. But yes, read the sentence from the book from the beginning.
Shibarakushite for a little while. Not a
Right.
little while, for a while.
A little while
Shite
is
is, I mean.
fine. It just means a unconfirmed amount of time. It doesn't actually have to be long. It's just like for a bit.
Shibarakushite muffin ga chairo ni natta no de. I confuse myself with the no there again. No, it's just a normalizer. There is the
Basically.
da. The
Yeah.
te for da. He's
Hi.
saying this and then that. So this happened and then the following thing happened.
That's true. That's mostly because of the
So
past tense, I would say there.
natta no de. Became the muffin became brown I gave it a try. I tasted it.
Yes. A lot of
I
times,
ate
no
it.
day will be translated as because. It is a weaker because than kara, but is a stronger because than te. Right? Te form we saw, which is just ingredient needed. So the no de is no, which isn't really nominalizer. We talked about this like way back, but it is taught as a nominalizer. If you look up this no in the dictionary, especially in like a Genki textbook, it's going to be saying this is the nominalizer no that you put after verbs. What this is actually doing is restatement. It's taking this whole clause and turning it into a noun to double on itself to make it more sure. It's the same thing as nda that you'll see at the end of certain sentences when people talk. So you can say, muffin ga chairo ni natta. That's the exact same thing. Chairo ni natta no da. Exact same sentence. Which is basically just stating this information in that kind of more aggressive, kind of talky person kind of way. But then we have the de to connect these two ideas together, right? To mean and, but kind of in a tool-like way. So a tool used in order to eat the muffin, what was something needed?
Chairo ni
It needed to
natta.
become brown, as in it needed to be cooked before he could take a bite, a trial bite out of it. So that's why this is a lot of times will be translated as cuz. Since the muffin became, after a while, since the muffin became brown, I decided to try to take a single bite out of it. That's how this would probably be generally translated. But yeah, it's just that doubling no, is kind of what I would describe it as. It's a doesn't really have an English. It's like pronoun no, what it is, you know, but then it's like restating itself twice. So it's the and then tu, te form. So yeah, any questions before we go?
No question, Money.